My name's Alyson Hunter and I'm a consultant obstetrician and subspecialist in foetal and maternal medicine in Wood Maternity Hospital in Belfast. Since I've been a consultant here, we have not been able to offer choice for women that do not want to continue a pregnancy with foetal abnormality. And it's extremely difficult to give this dreadful diagnosis to a woman. The heartbreak that she's already going through, knowing that her child is going to have a foetal or a very severe abnormality that's going to affect hers and her entire family's life. And she feels she cannot continue with that pregnancy. And there are multiple reasons why women cannot continue with these pregnancies. And then to have to say, we can't help you. And it has been absolutely awful to work in that situation where a woman has then, until very recently, had to go and arrange termination on her own. We don't know exactly where she's going, who's looking after her, what's going to happen to her. And for me, that has just been unacceptable and so difficult to work with as a doctor, because the whole thing about medicine is safety of your patients, and to see them devastated and then doubly devastated that they have to go away and be away from loved ones. I have stories of a woman who had a second really awful abnormality with her child, where the child was probably going to die very shortly after birth, or really have very low quality of life and die in its first few years of life. She had a second abnormality, so the first one she went to England, and the second one, when I told her again, she said, I just don't know whether I can go through this again. Ended up having to go to London and said she stood on one of the bridges outside the hospital she's attending and very, very seriously thought about throwing herself over the bridge. She had to go alone. Her partner couldn't get away. She couldn't tell people what was happening. So to me, the shame, the stigma, it's just wrong. It is just wrong. And for me, this is all about compassionate healthcare, compassionate and safe healthcare. Well, the gestation limit at 22 weeks is a limit that will deny women, particularly who are having a diagnosis of foetal abnormality, a lack of access to abortion. In Northern Ireland and the UK, most of the world, foetal anomaly scanning is at between 20 and 21 weeks gestation. And I think that's probably unlikely to change, because this is one of the best times to access and scan the foetal heart, for example. So if a woman is diagnosed at 21 weeks with a foetal abnormality, the next thing she will have to see a foetal maternal specialist like myself. It depends, we try and see them within a week, but it can be difficult. We are short-staffed here. And if she is then seen, she'll be asked if she wants to have investigations. So you're just pushing things further and further. So for many women, you know, to actually be seen by 22 weeks is actually quite a big ask. So if she's seen and then has to make a decision about abortion, if the time limit is 22 weeks, it will be impossible for many women. So I think then we are back to the situation where we were before October, where women will have to access termination of pregnancy across the water or elsewhere. Well, my the area that I've specialised in is in high-risk obstetrics and in foetal and maternal medicine. So foetal medicine is really the caring for women who have complex pregnancy. That can include things like foetal growth problems, prematurity, but it also includes foetal abnormality. So part of when we diagnose a foetal abnormality is to discuss the options for women. And the options in Northern Ireland until this change in October have been very limited, because unless the life of the mother has been at risk, then we have not been able to offer a woman with a foetal abnormality a termination of pregnancy if she wishes. So while myself and my colleagues have been able to look after women who continue with a pregnancy, and it is my privilege to do that and to look after these women, the other side of the argument is that with women that have not been able to carry on for whatever reason with the pregnancy, to as a doctor turn around and say, I cannot help you, and is just awful, to not know what is happening to a woman, that a woman has had to travel away, that she has not only the heartbreak of being told that her baby has a foetal or an extremely severe abnormality, she then has to have the added, and I would say an added burden of having to travel and access termination. And the issue that I have with that is, where is she going? How is she being cared for? Who's following her up? And in foetal abnormality, it's absolutely vital. We really encourage women with a foetal abnormality to get a post-mortem after an abnormality is diagnosed, so that we can try and counsel them about what happened very fully and think about the future. Because if they want more children, it is vital to know what has happened in this pregnancy. Is it hereditary? Is it likely to happen again? And to help plan another pregnancy. When women have gone away and had a termination, we haven't been able to arrange post-mortem in most cases. And that is just wrong. As a professional, as a woman that has trained, as a doctor who's trained in this area, to do that, it's absolutely, I mean, I have, I've been ashamed that that's the way that we have ended up caring for some women. And we have a little room, we often counsel women after we do a scan, to tell them what our findings are and what the outlook is. And the number of times that I have sat in that room over the years and told a woman, when she's asked about not continuing the pregnancy, we can't help her. It is absolutely devastating, and you can imagine the reactions of women, which has been from absolute horrific outpouring of grief to extreme anger, which I understand both of them. You know, to get to a situation now where we don't have to do that with women. And even recently, you know, in the last month, to have been able to see women with the termination, that wish a termination. I saw a lady with a foetal abnormality actually the second day after the change in the legislation, and be able to help her in our hospital, look after her, follow her up, get everything as it should be. Just, it's just such a weight off your shoulders, and for the woman as well. And actually she said to me, you know, I was watching the news, I can't believe this has happened to me, but I was watching the news, and she said, I was listening to this and I never thought I'd be involved or would want an abortion, but here I am. And she said, isn't it amazing what happens? Not in a good way for her, but, and now I can have this at home, whereas you would have told me before, like a week ago, I would have had to go away. And I said, that's absolutely right. So it's just such a huge change, and it's just such the right change for our women here. And I think it's very important in this consultation that we try and get everybody involved to realise that this is about women, this is about the complexity of pregnancy. And people can have their own views, and we should respect each other's views on things like abortion, but over the years I have seen, like this woman, she wouldn't have contemplated or thought an abortion was ever going to be on the cards for her. But I've seen people coming in and saying, I don't know why I'm here, because I'd never terminate a pregnancy. But when they go and think about it, they will. And the opposite is true. The people that might terminate carry on. So life's complex. People are complex. People don't fit into a box. And as somebody that works in this field, I'm just delighted that we can help all women now.